Previously on Sports Science, we brought in the biggest idiot on the planet to take a 50-mile-per-hour tennis ball to the testicles. That single hit generated millions of hits on the internet. But since most hits to the nuts in professional sports generate more force than 68 pounds, we decided to up the ante to see if someone can take a hit with at least 10 times that amount of force. We want to set a world record for the hardest blast to the nuts. To attempt to set this insane record, we found two of the bravest volunteers in the history of sports science. Karate experts Rod Sakernowski and Kirby Roy. Rod is a well-known international master of the martial arts. And his student, Kirby Roy, is a lethal black belt. Both Rod and Kirby claim they can take a colossal impact to the testicles and not feel a thing. How's that? By using a technique Rod created called Combat Key.
What is Combat Key?
Combat Key is the ability of a martial artist to be able to take a full power blow, strike, kick to a vital area of the human body and survive it without injury.
What's an example of a vital area?
Adam's apple, testicle, ribs, places where you would normally get hit by a good puncher or kicker and be put down immediately.
But getting to that point takes years of the most painful training known to man.
When I first began taking kicks to the testicles, there was a lot of fear involved. So I started to develop a system where I could get myself to higher levels of accepting the pain and the nausea. It takes about 5 years of good training.
5 years of taking thousands of kicks to the nuts? That's supposed to be good training? Rod may be the master of Combat Key, but his star student Kirby will be taking today's abuse. But Kirby may want to rethink getting his cojones crushed when he sees who we've brought in. 6'8", 290-pound big-time bruiser, Justice Smith. This American gladiator delivers beatdowns in MMA and K-1 fights.
I'm gonna try to send his nuts up to his skull. You know what I'm saying?
In his kicking power, our tech scan sensors reveal that Justice kicked with a whopping 1,000 pounds of force.
Yeah, ticket. That's the ticket.
That's like getting your testicles smashed by a sledgehammer.
Man, I feel for this guy.
This is quickly becoming the riskiest kick in sports science history. The tennis ball that hit our volunteer put him down with only 68 pounds of force. But a kick from Justice is actually 15 times more powerful. And it could easily break Kirby's pelvic bone or rupture a testicle.
In the name of science, I'm gonna hit this cat.
But before Kirby's rocks get rolled for our record-breaking kick, he's offered to show his technique for taking massive blows to vital areas. So he's going to take a punch to the Adam's apple.
Kirby, have you ever been struck by a man this big?
He's big.
So Justice is the biggest human being you've ever been struck by?
Yeah. Biggest arms.
That's all that count, baby.
You ready to do this?
Let's do it.
Yes!
Justice's chop smashes into Kirby's neck with over 600 pounds of force. That's like having a 16-pound bowling ball drop on your neck from 9 feet. But Kirby shows no effect from the vicious hit.
You felt fine. You don't have a sore throat or anything?
I'm thirsty.
At 50 years old, he's, he got the body of steel, I guess.
In most cases, a chop like that would have crushed a person's trachea, possibly resulting in death. Yet Kirby is somehow unaffected by this massive hit to the neck.
He took your best shot.
It was definitely a good shot, but the result just made me feel like a little punk.
It's time for us to move on to the big blow, straight to the testicles. You're ready to just take Justice's best kick straight to the nuts, right?
We wire up Kirby with a heart monitor to get a baseline reading of his pulse. Last season, when our amateur daredevil got nailed in the nads, his pulse redlined at 182 beats per minute. So when Kirby gets jacked in the jump, his heart rate should skyrocket.
Can you pull tight? I mean, clearly there is nothing.
There's no cup. They're there.
There's nothing. So if I just go whack, you're not protected at all.
There's no protection.
You ready to do this?
I'm ready to do it.
You ready to do this?
Can Kirby take the kick like a man? Or will Justice's boot destroy his manhood?
3, 2, 1, go.
In the sports science lab, American gladiator and MMA fighter Justice Smith is ready to deliver a world record kick to combat key expert Kirby Roy's nuts. A boot that could cause a pelvic fracture or severe testicular injury. Can Kirby withstand the pain? Or will the kick turn his avocados into guacamole?
3, 2, 1, go.
That all on my shins, like, man.
That was a strong kick.
Man, no cup, no nothing, bro. It's just straight up nuts.
How did that feel?
It was a very strong, direct kick. He had his shin into it. I mean, I could feel it coming up.
Wow.
Justice's foot rockets into Kirby's crotch at 22 miles an hour. Landing with 1,100 pounds of force. That's even more powerful than his baseline kick. But instead of crumpling up and going full fetal, Kirby shrugs it off like it's nothing. How was Kirby able to take the massive impact below the belt and feel nothing? When Kirby's kicked in the groin, warning signals rocket to his brain at 265 miles an hour. In fractions of a second, the brain sends signals back down into the abdomen and testicles, and a neural transmitter that tells the brain it's feeling pain is released. It's called Substance P. But after 5 years and thousands of the most painful shots to the nuts, Kirby's nerves process only 10% of the substance P that a normal person would process, which means his brain no longer receives a message of pain.
Your heart rate has not changed at all.
Wow.
Previously, in our tennis ball experiment, our subject's pulse redlined at 182 beats per minute after being plunked in the plums. But Kirby? Astonishingly, his heart rate stayed exactly the same, 85 beats per minute before, during, and after the kick. It's another sign that his brain isn't processing substance P.
That was the hardest kick. I mean, the impact of it was tremendous.
Your shin went right up into his groin. What did you feel?
I felt his pelvic bone and also a couple of nuts as well. But, dude, it was a real kick. Yeah, at least two. It was real.
Substance P explains why Kirby didn't end up all wadded up, gasping for breath. But it doesn't explain how Kirby's pelvis and testicles weren't seriously damaged. After taking thousands of kicks to the groin for 5 years, Kirby's testicles toughened. And these repeated impacts created millions of microfractures in his pelvic bones. Due to an anatomical phenomenon called Wolf's Law, these fractures actually heal stronger, transforming those calcified bones into a substance harder than rock. That's right, Kirby stones are actually like stones.
I definitely tried to hit him as hard as I could. Really didn't faze him. But my mind was like, dude, I don't think he hit him hard because he's still standing, you know?
I gotta tell you, I was a total skeptic coming into this, but there was no trick to this.
No trick at all. I know the average guy would have been on his deathbed.
So if you want to challenge this new world record, keep in mind the words of the ancient Greek philosopher Testicles. Bravery and stupidity are often two peas in the same pod.
Those are unbelievable places, bro. A man shouldn't get hit that way.